She's one of my daughters. She received the Lord, got born again here. She's been here for about 30-something years, about 36 years, and thank God for you. Amen. You will be hearing more of the daughters coming forth. Yeah. Hey, Bishop, you see how the women are clapping their hands? Hey. They are praying some prayers. That is powerful. Few things we want to deal with. We want to pray for Nigeria and pray for the peace of Nigeria. And it is important that we pray for the peace of Nigeria, because whatever happens there can affect Ghana here. So we shouldn't just sit down here and think that we are safe. We are not. We are only safe if Nigeria is safe. And we can't be safe with this coronavirus until everybody is safe. It is that dangerous, because if you think you are safe, I was talking to a couple the other day, and the husband said that the wife went out, and he didn't know where she went to. And when she came back, she was coughing. So she told the wife that, "Madam, I think you should go and stay in the guest room." And the wife also said, "My friend, you two, you've been going out. So what is the problem? I'm not staying in any guest room." And it was becoming an issue. And the fact of the matter is that nobody is safe except faith in God. That's the fact of the matter. Yeah. We are not safe anywhere. And that's why for me, I've made up my mind, I'm not missing church. Because, you know, at the end of the day, they are saying that it's airborne. I flew recently to New York, 10 hours, 30 minutes on the flight, 10 hours, 30 minutes. And when I was coming in Africa, we're on our own. Because when I was coming, I came with British Airways, I went through London. And the British Airways aircraft from Washington, D.C. to London was different from the one from London to Ghana. The one from London to Ghana is the old one where the seat is tight for husband and wife. But the one from Washington to London is Corona one. It's made for Corona. Social distance. The one from London to Africa, no social distance. So I got it and I said, "As for us, it's only God." I'm telling you, that is the truth. It's only God. You know, and even the, I was talking to some scientist friends of mine in Washington, and they said that, "Listen, this vaccine you people are depending on, the fact of the matter is that they haven't planned for Africa. They are thinking about how to preserve themselves first. So as for us, we have to build strong faith in God." I'm telling you. And we have to believe God that you won't get it, and even if you get it, that it won't kill you, you won't die. Yeah, you have to have that faith. Because if you don't develop that faith, the fear of the virus itself will make you, as soon as your wife coughs, you say, "Madam, can you enter the other room, please? I beg you." You won't eat. You won't see your husband. You won't see your... You don't have to deal with anybody. It's a very serious thing. Because I was talking to one of my staff. She takes about 3 cars before she gets to the office. So I was saying that between the 3 cars and the time she gets to the office here, anything could have happened. Lift up your right hand. Say, "In the name of Jesus, any openings around me that the enemy would deploy to access me with the coronavirus and any other virus or any sickness or any situation, any demonic current or energy, say by executive power, by executive order, through the blood of Jesus, I block those openings." Put your hands together. Block it in the name of Jesus. I block it. I block those openings. I block it. Let it be blocked in the name of Jesus. You will not be accessed. Your family will not be accessed. Your children will not be accessed. Your loved one will not be accessed. No one that concerns this house or anyone here, home and abroad, domestic or external, will be accessed. There will be no loss of lives in the name of Jesus. Now, quickly, before we pray for the peace of Nigeria, the Bible says in Numbers 31:49, he said, we have counted all the men under your command, and there is no loss of anyone. We make a decree today by executive order through the blood of Jesus that there will be no loss of anyone that concerns us, anyone that concerns this house, home and abroad, wherever they are, even if they are careless, wherever they are, let their life be preserved. Let there be no loss of any life or anyone, young or old, great and small, between now and the end of this year and after. Make a declaration. You have to open your mouth. You must make a declaration. Say it. That I proclaim by executive order through the blood of Jesus that there will be no loss of any son or daughter, of anyone that concerns me and this house, home and abroad, between now and the end of this year and thereafter. There shall be no loss. There shall be no loss of any life or anyone that concerns us. Make that decree and declaration by executive order through the blood of Jesus. For thou shalt decree a thing, Job 22, verse 28, and it shall stand. Thou shalt decree a thing, and it shall be established unto thee, and a light shall shine upon thy ways. Upon thy ways. Make a decree. Make a decree. In the name of Jesus, make a decree. Now, thank you. Now, we want to send prayers to Nigeria. We want to pray. Let every curse on the land responsible for that uprising, that thing you are seeing in Nigeria, is a window. It's a wind. And the leaders of Africa have to sit up. I'm telling you. That thing, the soldiers cannot kill it. It's going to take negotiation, reasoning, and changing some policies and changing things. And giving the youth hope and jobs, opportunity. Yeah. It's some kind of a curse on the land that doesn't allow leaders to do the right thing. That makes leaders become greedy and selfish and self-centered and don't have compassion and don't have love for country and don't care of what they do. And it's a curse responsible for that, that will cause that kind of uprising. And it doesn't matter how many they kill, they will rise. Because these are people who don't have anything to lose. They are not married, they don't have wives, they don't have children, they don't have a land, they don't have property, they don't have anything. So when you are dealing with people who have nothing to lose, you have to be very careful. Because they don't care dying. Even though they might be afraid of dying, they really don't care. Talula wasihati. Hey, katabahas. Let's lift up prayer for the peace of the nation of Nigeria. And break any curse over the ground and the land that causes leaders to miss it. And let's pray for the leaders of Africa. That they will have love for country, love for their people, love for their nation, and give the future generation hope. Let's lift up prayer for the leaders of Africa, from Nigeria, across the continent, and pray for the peace thereof. For it is in the peace thereof shall we have a no peace. We arrest the spirit of violence, shedding of blood, any curse on the land that requires innocent blood, let the curse be lifted, let the curse be broken over the land in the name of Jesus. We command every curse by executive order that demands the blood of innocent people to be lifted and broken on the land in the name of Jesus. Hear me. One more prayer we must pray. Still praying for Nigeria and the nations of Africa. We must pray that any curse on the land of Nigeria and the nations of Africa that demands innocent blood at certain times and seasons, because this thing can cause a lot of bloodshed if it is not managed and handled well with the way it's going. and it can skip, it can move to other countries of Africa. So we want to pray that the curse in the land that requires and demands innocent blood and life at certain times and seasons in the histories of nations of Africa, as you look all over the place, we have to pray for Cote d'Ivoire also. Pray for all the nations of Africa, Liberia, Sierra Leone. There is something that demands blood on this continent, in the nations of Africa, and it's a curse. Let the curse, by executive order, through the blood of Jesus, be lifted. Let the curse be broken. Any argument the enemy puts up to demand blood, the life of innocent men and women, and sons and daughters and children on this continent, by the blood of Jesus, let the curse be broken and let the argument be dismantled. Open your mouth, somebody, wherever you are, all over the nations. Pray for Nigeria and the nations of Africa and the continent of Africa. Let the curse that demands the blood of innocent people on this continent and causes unrest, civil wars and unrest, in the name of Jesus, to take human life and blood, let the curse be dismantled. Let the curse be broken. Let the curse be lifted by the power of Jesus' name. Somebody, open your mouth. Pray that prayer right now. In the name of Jesus, let the curse be lifted. Let the curse be lifted. Let the curse be lifted. Let the curse be broken. Let every satanic argument the enemy puts us to demand the life of innocent blood, to demand the blood of innocent people in Nigeria, across the nations of Africa, in the name of Jesus, let the curse be lifted. Let the curse be broken. Let innocent lives, men and women, children, mothers, wives, husbands, be preserved, 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 in the name of Jesus, preserved. Now, another prayer we must pray quickly before we close. Let's pray that fathers and mothers will not bury their children. I'm telling you, this thing, it has some serious implications that if you think deep and you look at other African countries and other nations that has lost their youth, it has some serious implications. Let's make a decree by executive order through the blood of Jesus that fathers and mothers in Nigeria and across the continent of Africa shall not bury their sons and bury their daughters. Make that declaration right now in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Lift up prayer. Make a declaration. Don't hold your peace. It is dangerous to be at peace in Zion, to sit at ease. It is risky and dangerous to hold your peace. We decree and declare by the blood of the Lamb that no father and mother, home and abroad, in Nigeria and across the nations of Africa and beyond, shall bury their sons, nor their daughters, nor their grandchildren. Let the lives of the youth of this continent and Nigeria be precious in your sight, O Lord. Let the life of the youth of Africa and Nigeria and across the continent be precious in your sight, O Lord, I pray. In the name of Jesus, we pray for the peace of Africa, the peace of Nigeria, Cote d'Ivoire, the peace of Lome, Togo. Pray for the peace of Togo. Pray for Burkina Faso. Pray for Liberia, Sierra Leone, La Cote d'Ivoire, Uganda, Kenya, in the name of Jesus, South Africa, in the Namibia, in the name of Jesus, we lift up prayer. We make atonement. We make atonement. Let peace prevail within our walls and our borders, in the name of Jesus, that our fathers and our mothers will not bury their sons, nor daughters, nor grandchildren, by any means, in the name of Jesus. Talaya kutalasiya, amala gadili kisata. Amen. We need to take our offering and close by Friday. We have a strong prayer meeting for families. We'll continue to stand in the gap for Nigeria. Have prayer meetings for families and for 2020 election. It's important that we pray. Please get your envelopes, get ready to give. We got to go home. And it's very important that you are part of the prayer meetings, and I'm speaking to those online, inviting everybody to join us in prayer. If you truly care and love this country, from 7 p.m. to 9 p.m., 2 hours, there'll be a short exhortation of the word, and we'll get into prayer to intercede that the 2020 election, God will give us a divine outcome, that curses and pronunciations that have been made to determine the outcome of the election that will compromise the peace and security of Ghana, to bring confusion and any form of unrest in this nation, will be aborted in the name of Jesus. That the hand of the Lord shall rest upon this country. And the Bible said that men cast the lot, but the Lord determines the outcome. Let God and the prayers of the saints determine the outcome of this election. Amen. Amen.